8-bit instrumentation.
Amplified is produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc. and NVX. We are also sponsored by US Alternators, DownForSoundShop.com, and Surfshark. Surfshark increases your privacy online and hides your IP address and physical location by encrypting all of your web traffic and routing it through their secure servers. Surfshark is more than just a VPN. Surfshark includes HackLock ID protection, blind search, smart DNS, clean web filter, and more. Surfshark is totally unlimited. Use it on as many devices as you want, even all at the same time. Change your server location to access geo-restricted content on Netflix, Disney Plus, and other streaming services, and unlock geo-restricted pricing. Surfshark has 24/7 customer support and a 30-day money-back guarantee. Try Surfshark using our link in the video description, surfshark.deals/soundman, and get 83% off and 3 months free. Look what I bought for us to play with today. This is a Sony high-powered head unit. Today I'm going to experiment with the Sony DSX GS80 for use with iPad vehicular integrations. Roll the dumb. With a max of 140 W's by 4. Dad. Do you even believe that amount of W's? Okay, now what we have here today is a little experimentation. We have a USB-C to digital AV multi-port Apple adapter unit. Take a look at the back of that. This is gonna give us a HDMI out. We have a fast charger available on my Amazon store. I wanna test a head unit to go with the iPad installs. My favorite head unit to ever exist is this Sony RSX GS9. This plays raw 5.6 megahertz DSD files from an iPad. It has an optical out and it has really good RCA pre-outs. The amount of flack this thing's putting out, I don't even know if you can get these anymore. This must be extinct. And it's expensive. It's a $1,500 unit. Okay. This baby's 300s. I want to see if we can get a nice iPad setup going with a cheaper head unit to give people a more full feature functionality. What I think we can do here is hook up to a fast charger, because some head units, the USB doesn't put out enough to charge the iPad. So we can cure that with this situation. Let me unravel this. This is a USB-C to USB-A from Mophie. Damn, look at it, look at it. This is the Anopy fast charging adapter for vehicular use. This is a vehicular unit. This will go 12 volts to a fast charge situation with this Chinese pussy hole. You put this in the pussy hole.
Oh.
This is a female cigarette lighter plug. Now you can hide this behind your dasharoni. We got a USB-C. Let's unbox this.
Ooh-wee.
Now you see how this is gonna work. It's gonna give us a fast charging right into this port. Look at that. Fast charging into the portal. And then this is going into the pad, and then USB is going into the head unit with this USB cable that I don't have. What do I not have? Oh shit. My plan here is to test a few new methods of wiring the iPad to your vehicle's car stereo system. After all, no one else is going to do it. We can't expect Mark Zuckerberg, the car audio nerd, to do anything new. He already copied all my old videos. And now he's on to regurgitating the mobile solutions content. It's been very satisfying to see the DIY audio guy remake the next generation of car stereo how-to videos. After all, the DIY audio guy is Mark's real father. So I want to see if an iPad can go straight into this, and I want to see if we could use it like this with the fast charger. This will give us HDMI out and a USB to the head unit. DSX GS80. DSX. Wow, it's hot. DS Sexual. Look at that. What I like about this is it's nice looking. It's got a nice knob. It's got USB on the back. And it's got 3 pre-outs, 5 volts. And it has a remote in, which is important if you're trying to retain your OEM steering wheel controls. You can connect this up to an optional adapter, hook up to your steering wheel controls, hide this head unit behind the iPad, and you have yourself a setup. Let me tell you, baby. Let me tell you. Let me tell you. Whore knee, baby. This is the whore's knee. Look at this. Now look, everyone's asking about the base war. I don't give a shit about EXO's baffle board. He's had his van a year longer than me. He hasn't even started his door panels yet. Okay, give me a minute. Give me a goddamn. Bear with me, I'll get back on the base van as soon as I can. I need to get through some of these dash mod projects. I've been sharing my dash mods on TikTok, and I've become a TikTok celebrity. Millions more views than Mark Zuckerberg, the car audio nerd's TikTok. It's no comparison.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
We used the Soundman 12.9-inch iPad Pro kit, which accommodates this 90-degree USB-C. See, we got a USB-C here. Do you see? USB-C, what I'm saying? Now look. Well, we almost dropped it. USB-C, what I mean with these? Look at that, huh? This makes it nice for the customer, so the customer can choose. Does he want to go this way? What scenario do you need? I don't know. What kind of truck is it? Oh, it's an Excursion. We have our power supply. We got a real simple wire up job we're gonna do here. We'll give it a linesman splice. Look at that! Extra bass this has. That's why you buy this head unit. Sorcerer. USB 1, USB 1, USB 2. Oh, we need speakers over here. How the hell are we gonna hear noise? We got the fast charger putting out 13.7 to the Mophie. Okay, if you guys are following along. Now we're gonna see if the Apple can handle 13.7 in the USB-C hole. All right, this is going in the back of the dash mod. Ooh, look at her. She's charging. Is she charging? Oh no. She's not charging, boss. How could it not be charging? Okay, so it doesn't charge. Let's try right to the Mophie. Oh, now it's charging. See? You see that? Well, that's stupid. All right, let's see how it does on the Sony. Straight into the Sony. I don't know why that wouldn't allow it to charge. That says it charges. USB 2 overload. Look.
Look.
We overloaded the USB. See, it's not gonna work like that. USB 2 overload. Okay, you see? You know what I think we need to do? I think we need to go USB straight to the charger and then USB-C to the head unit. And then I need to find a USB-A to USB-A. Give me 1 minute, I'll be right. Give me 1 second. Quiet on the set. All right. What in the world is going on here? This deck will hook up to your car's OEM steering wheel controls with an optional adapter. You get 3 sets of pre-outs, front, rear, and sub. For your aftermarket amps, you can build a full system. and you have the ability to play high-resolution FLAC files from the iPad through the Sony. How do you like them apples? Is what Steve Jobs said to Tim Cook. What did Steve Jobs say to Tim Cook when Steve showed Tim his bare nutsack? I'll give you a hint. It has to do with apples. Quiet on the set.
Connecting speaker.
Okay, we're having technical difficulties. So through the rear USB, it says overload. Front USB doesn't say overload. Listen to this. I got Kids Bop on here. Family friendly, baby. Oh, damn. That's my child's Kids Bop. Let's listen to the Zombies 3 album. Okay. Alien Invasion. Who knows about it? I'm gonna go into the settings, go into the power menu, and see what the charge is looking like. Looks like we're charging. I'm gonna try a USB-C wiener, 12 volt wiener penis. And this thing ain't doing dick for me. That blows turds. This blows a mega amount of turds. Can I hit, where do I hit the? So far, this $79 Apple dildo doesn't do dick. Apple crap. Every time I play with an Apple device, I get turned off. An Apple a day makes my boner go away. Keeps my boner away. However you want to say it. Sick of it. An Android really sounds good right about now. And I'm talking about a male sex robot. I'm already getting fucked by technology, I may as well enjoy it. Cockford Ballsgate! My goal is to come up with multiple options for every vehicle, for optimum functionality. I'm talking from Buick LeSabre to Subaru Snoutback. Guess which one a fat lesbian pig drives? Spoiler alert, it's the Snoutback.
Doug, right now it's not time for this. Right now it's not the...
Take a look at this, you fucking bitch. Oh.
It's the next day. I have some more adapters to test. Spoiler, nothing works.
Let me get my unboxing thumb. Okay, we're gonna get this. We're gonna open this right here.
Ooh.
I don't wanna damage the box. Half the shit's going back. That dumb Apple cable doesn't work. Okay? Apple crap. Tim Cook said you could film a movie on an iPhone 13. I can't even get a YouTube video out with it.
Okay, look, this is important. This is bitching if you wanna go right in the front pussy of her, huh? So look what we have here, see? So if this is installed in the dash, you dock your iPad.
Ooh.
Then you got a USB back here.
Ooh.
This can go either way, depending on your situation. Look at that. And then if you're going in the front, we got this situation.
Oh, look it. That's horny, baby.
It's small enough to where if you fit the deck behind the iPad, you could just make a little notch for this cable to run in, since that rear port ain't working very swell. And this is dead. Let's see if this Sony has what it takes to bring this baby back to life, eh? And I got these. This is a little Belkin double USB-C doodad. You see? I'm thinking this might get us into the rear input and charge it, and it may not have an overloading situation. Apple USB-C to the Belkin fast charging unit to the dildo to the fucking... And this one says audio, so we're gonna go high quality Mophie USB-C to A. This is the rear Sony USB. Let's see what happens when I give her a plug in. Now this can plug into the 90 degree. Look, it popped on.
because we're fast charging, baby. See, this would be ideal because we'll get the fast charger and
we could play audio over USB, over the rear USB.
So far, after a day of extensive experimentation, turns out it works best if you just plug the iPad into the front USB port of the Sony. Who would have thought? I expected more complicativity. Expected! It even knows it's playing Elton John from YouTube. Wow!
It works best plugged right into the front. Let's see what happens with the 11 plugged into the rear.
Okay, so this doesn't do anything. The Belkin sucks. Everything sucks.
The way this works best is just to go right from the iPad to the front of the Sony. It charges it. When it turns off, it pauses. Let's see what happens when we turn it back on.
Autoplay functionality, baby. It starts playing when you turn it on. This Sony deck allows you to use a steering wheel control adapter. So if you have OEM steering wheel controls, you can install the single DIN steering wheel control adapter. This can hide behind your iPad in this kind of situation. And you'll be able to control volume and all that from the steering wheel controls. And when you turn your vehicle off, it'll pause the iPad. Most of the time you're gonna wanna undock it from your dash.
So I'd say that's pretty horny for $300. Dang,
I wish the rear USB worked. What can you expect for $300?
I got a feeling down deep in my hole.
Some of you guys who have been into car stereo since the 90s say that Sony left a bad taste in your mouth. Ever since the X-Plod series. Well, you didn't have to put it in your mouth. If you didn't suck on it, it wouldn't leave a taste in your mouth. Fucking weirdo. You're lucky it didn't X-Plod.
Ooh.
Now we got the 12.9, we got maps going over here. Okay, we're gonna get some, let's find a restaurant. Okay. The Cluckin' Chicken. Son of a clucking bitch, only 4 minutes away? Shit, I'll be right down.
Starting route to the Clucking Chicken.
Yeah, bitch! So this is a pretty horny setup. $300 Sony, plug it right in the front. It doesn't seem to fast charge, so you could hook it up to a fast charger. This Belkin USB-C, use the Apple cable, go right into the back of her, and pair over Bluetooth. The advantage of that is you could undock the iPad and Lionel Richie could still be singing over your Bluetooth.
You're feeling down deep in my hole.
What happened? Oh, it's the next song. It started over. And if your vehicle doesn't have steering wheel controls, you can still hide this behind there. You put an IR repeater. And you got yourself a little wireless hidden. That would be sweet. That'd be pretty slick. I've come to the conclusion that this all comes down to compatibility. Compatibility? What did I almost say? Quiet on the set. The question is, which iPad works best with which deck? First of all, we narrowed down the equipment choices based on rules we already know. First rule, Pioneers are for queers. Rule two, Ken would. Turns out Ken wouldn't. Rule three, can't floss if you run a boss. Boss decks are out. They never should have been. Rule four, the Alpine Type S is an Alpenis. We can't run a deck that says Al Penis on the front. It can't say penis. Disqualification. That leaves us with a Sony, which is short for so horny. Purchase industry-leading iPad dash kits from the originator at soundman.co. Your car deserves the best. Update your car with an iPad dash kit from soundman.co. Find high-quality car audio gear at nvx.com. NVX is committed to audio quality and innovation. Their high-end car audio components are rated accurately, and they've been proven to perform since 2011. Try NVX at nvx.com.